Majora's Mask is one of the most popular Zelda games in history, and also one of the weirdest. Just look at the moon! In this game, you don't fight Ganondorf or save Zelda. No. This time around, Link fights a powerful and evil mask, which is a fun twist. Besides this, there are a lot more differences between this game and all the others in the series, like the 3-day cycle you repeat until you beat the game. Overall, an interesting concept, and people liked it a lot for its differences. So of course, Nintendo did the unthinkable. They made a remake. Funny enough, Majora's Mask 3D was referred to internally as Joker. The reason for this became apparent when looking at the internal names of the other Zelda games released in the same time frame. Ocarina of Time 3D is known as Queen, The Wind Waker HD is known as King, and A Link Between Worlds is known as Jack, while Triforce Heroes is known as Alice. The last one might seem out of place, until you remember the playing card elements in a classic tale of Alice in Wonderland, which this seems to be a reference to. Clearly, they have some fun at the development studios of Nintendo. Now, in the files for this now 3DS game are some interesting things like test levels, different layouts for areas, and some odd character models. Let's start with taking a look at the different areas. First up, some grottos. These are underground caves where monsters may hide and valuable treasure often lies.
The first one is named Kakusiana 6. In the Japanese version of the N64 Majora's Mask, the path to get to the magic bean cellar at Deku Palace was much different. The player had to enter the left garden rather than the right one and pass through several enemy-filled grottos to get to the one with a salesman inside. In the international release and the most later versions of the game, including this one, the path was greatly simplified so that the player only has to sneak through a much smaller garden on the right and drop into a hole. Despite their removal, the map data for the removed grottos remains in Majora's Mask 3D, although their textures and actor data were removed. The vertically oriented cave originally contained two climbing walls, a few skull watchulas, and a horde of black bows. Now, it's kind of weird that this is in the files, since it's not used in most versions of the older game. It is known, however, that Majora's Mask 3D was based on the N64 version. We don't exactly know which one, though. This doesn't have to do anything with the files, as these grottos are also existent and can even be accessed through glitches in the international versions, as just their entries were removed. However, it is a little strange that they didn't care at all about the files and just modified the map data itself, leaving the Japanese-only maps in the game. Now, there's also a second unused grotto in the files, named Kakusiana 8. This grotto, on the other hand, is much simpler. The circular area cut out of the shrubs in the middle of the area housed a Deku Baba in the original Japanese release. This proves once again that the game was mostly just built on the original game files of the N64 game. And there is even more evidence supporting this, since the test map from the N64 version of the game can be found in the files as well. It's the same as Testa 1-0 Info CSI, but it uses less meshes, has no textures, and is missing the correct texture for the water. This one was clearly copy-pasted from the N64 version of the game, which once again proves that they just copied the files for the remake and just modified the ones that had to be modified. The test level itself is quite interesting. It's filled with all kinds of platforms, ramps, and some water here and there. There are even ladders, but the textures for them are off and they don't function properly. A classic test room, as you can see. Now, for some reason, Grezzo altered the position of Tingle's object in an unused scene setup of North Clock Town. All of a sudden, he's a lot closer to the Great Fairy Fountain, so he moved quite a bit, and we think that wasn't their goal. This must have been a mistake, since it's so extremely far off for no reason at all.
Now let's move on to something a bit sinister and creepy, since the kids that run around in the moon aren't the same anymore. The Moon Children's model has a very disturbing unseen feature. Their faces are identical to the Happy Mask salesman's. This is in contrast to the N64 version, in which their faces were not textured. So, why would they do that now then? And why the Happy Mask salesman? Well, Nintendo knows that this game has a mysterious and creepy vibe, so maybe they wanted to add something to this effect. The Happy Mask salesman is one of the characters we know the least about in the entire game, so putting this in will make it even more weird and interesting. And this is exactly what happened. As soon as fans found out this was a thing, they went nuts. Now, besides all these weird and interesting things in the files, there was also a disappointment. In the European version, there's an additional language message file called EUD.GMSG and only contains the word link. The name suggests that Dutch may have been an additional language, which makes me sad, as some of you might know why. Thiefbug, the one I work with together to make these videos, is from Germany, and I'm from the Netherlands, so I'm Dutch, and I never got my subtitles. So this news makes me a bit sad. I could have had a Dutch Zelda experience, but no, Nintendo didn't give me that. Thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed. If you want to watch more videos, click the annotations on the screen right now. And be sure to click the little bell next to the subscribe button. And also click the subscribe button, because then you won't miss any videos.